Hey guys, it's Mike from the Geek Pub, and on this episode, we're going to install this awesome 19-inch network rack. Okay, so as you can see, when we moved into the house, the builder had this panel installed, and the AV company that did it did probably the piss-poorest job that I've ever seen in my entire life. And so, unfortunately, that's what we have to work with. And I don't believe I'm going to change this because I think it would be too much trouble, and I'm afraid that the wiring won't reach if I try to put a real patch panel in here and try to wire this correctly. All the cables test to spec, so I'm just going to leave that the way it is. What we are going to do is we're going to put a 19-inch rack right here, and we're going to bolt that to the wall. And then we'll move all of these switches. So as you can see here, I've got these IKEA shelves, and basically all my network gear, my firewall, my switches, my NVR for my cameras, my UPS, everything is just sitting here on these IKEA shelves because there's no possible way they were going to go in there. And so with that, they'll go in this 19-inch rack. Now, the problem is the wall does not have any studs that are 16 inches on center, and unfortunately that's what my rack needs to bolt to the wall. So what I will do first is put a sheet of plywood on the wall. I'll run that into the studs, and then we'll bolt the rack up to the plywood. And so let's get started and cut a sheet of plywood. So the first thing I did was measure the wall, and it came out to about 27 3/4 inches. So I cut it to about 1/16 of an inch shy of that. The plywood I used was 3/4 inch cabinet grade pine, and my wife was very nice to help me push it through the saw. I attached the plywood to the wall about 3 feet off the ground using 9 2.5 inch drywall screws. I then marked and pre-drilled the 4 holes for the rack bolts, and then ran the bolts in halfway. From there, you can just hang the rack on the 4 bolts. It just slides into the slots. And to finish it off, I used a socket wrench to tighten the bolts securely because I could not find my impact driver bits. I also installed 4 D-rings that will be used for cable management, 2 for the data cabling and 2 for the power cables. In the bottom of the rack, I installed a 10 outlet rack mount power strip that will provide power for the rack equipment. It takes up 1 U of rack space, but it makes power management much easier. The next thing I did was use some masking tape and labeled all of my cables. This way I can put everything back in the same port so that my VLANs and my firewall rules won't be affected. Then it's just a matter of installing all of the equipment in the rack and plugging the cables back in. After I got all the cables in place, I used some Velcro wrap to bundle and secure them about every 6 inches. So the rack that I bought is a really nice rack. It's a really heavy duty, sturdy unit. The one thing I don't like is it has this big hole up here in the top of it. And because I want to be able to set things on top, such as my server and my NVR and some things like that, that aren't rack mountable. And so what I did was I got this cheap IKEA shelf that it happens to be the exact same size as the rack itself, and I'm just going to hold it on with some industrial Velcro. That way I can always remove it anytime I want very easily, but it will make the perfect shelf for setting stuff on top. First up, my NVR. Follow that up with my Plex Media Server NAS. Then a couple of PCs from work I'm using for a lab, and the hard drives in the cradle I'm using for the same lab. Okay, well that wraps up the installation of the network rack. There's a couple things left that I want to do. The first one is I want to mount this Airport Extreme, which is my wireless for the upstairs. I want to mount it either up here on the pegboard or maybe even higher up on the wall, I'm not sure. But my total mount did not come in in time for the video, and so unfortunately I won't be able to show you that. But it's basically just a cup that goes on the bottom and then it mounts anywhere on the wall. The second thing that I think I'm going to go ahead and do is clean this up. And I know I don't want to do it, but I just, after seeing all of this completed, I just feel like I need to do that. So probably I won't make a video about it, but probably I'll go ahead and clean that up. Well, that wraps up the video. Thank you so much for watching. Please do me a favor and like this video and subscribe to my channel on YouTube. And if you want to go more in depth on this project, head over to thegeekpub.com. Well, stay tuned for a future video, and I'll give you a tour of my home network.